Hi, and welcome to the Plugin Autopsy for Deep Glow. So Deep Glow, we have some pretty cool features coming up, but you know what else we have coming up? More YouTube content. I want to die now. So I've always been a massive fan of using glows, even when they're not required. I just love to add glows into pretty much everything that I do. Add some glows, chromatic aberration, film grain. Just can't get enough. And I'd always played around with pretty much every glow out there. And I always wondered, why are these glows so much better than the default glow in After Effects? And so I did a little bit of digging and found out that in the real world, light behaves according to the laws of physics. And there's a law called the inverse square law, where essentially, as light gets further away from the light source, it falls off exponentially. The default glow in After Effects is an additive blur.
Additive blur. So let's go ahead and add our own ghetto glow. An adjustment layer here, add a Gaussian blur, make it really big, and then add that back onto the original. And there we have it. We have our own glow. And it's perfect. So that's the end of this tutorial series. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
Which sort of has a linear fall off. And I'm sure you know there's a pretty big difference between a linear fall off and an exponential fall off. That's why the default glow doesn't look very good. However, you can emulate this inverse square fall off by essentially duplicating copies of the glow, the default After Effects glow. And you start the radius very small, say one or two. And then for every copy of the glow that you have, you double the radius, and that creates the exponential fall off because the radius keeps doubling each time. So eventually the last glow in the stack will be a radius of 1,000 or 2,000. And that's what gives you a nice natural looking result. The issue is that now you have 10 copies of the default glow atop your layer, and that's incredibly computationally expensive and wasteful. But your result looks good. And essentially I made a preset that was 10 glows, controlled by some sliders, and sold that on VideoHive in 2014, I think it was.
Deep Glow is a preset that gives you the best looking glows every time with minimal tweaking.
People really liked the result. It was just an absolute bottleneck on the CPU resources because the default glow at that time, and I don't know if it still does, use the CPU. I liked the result, but I wanted to sort of speed it up somehow. And when I got into plugin development, that was one of the first things I did. I started building a glow plugin, and I wasn't very good at plugin development at the start, and I sort of, after a year, had a product that I thought looked good, but it was still really slow. It was running on the CPU, and then that's when I realized, well, getting a good quality result is only half the battle because the other half is it needs to be quick. And so kind of canned that. It was never released, but it sort of taught me a thing or two about plugin development. Put it on pause for a year or two. And then the current glow on aescripts at the time was called Real Glow. It was a very good looking glow. It was on the CPU, it was pretty slow. I think everyone agrees it looked great, but it was still a bit slow. And I think the devs of that, for whatever reason, chose they didn't want to keep supporting it. And so that was discontinued. So there was a gap in the market there, and I thought, now is my opportunity for world domination with a glow plugin. I can finally release it. But then I had to actually make it. And I'd done some GPU plugins before, not many, and GPUs can do certain things very well and certain things they don't. And blurs are something that GPUs do quite efficiently. In a lot of video games these days, there's some very cool visual effects. I think it's probably referred to more as bloom in computer games, but they're very popular. And so there's been a lot of research done into creating these beautiful glows that run in real time, because when you're playing a computer game, you can't wait for the frames to render. You need it to be, you know, 60 frames per second. So if you have a glow, you need it to look good and you need it to run really fast at 60 frames per second. And so there's been heaps of research done into optimizing how to get these good looking results, or sort of like a trade-off between quality and speed. and basically heaps of examples online of how to squeeze every bit of performance out of these algorithms. And so I basically stole all this research, sort of combined it into Deep Glow, which only runs on the GPU. I wouldn't have a clue on how to make it run on the CPU, and it would probably be very slow. But essentially, it's doing the same thing. It's taking the original image, blowing it a little bit, and then blowing it a bit more. Each time the blur doubles, and then put them all back together, slap it on top. We've added some features like aspect ratio, so that is sort of more like a directional blur going on there. That's using a different algorithm.
What's your favorite way to use Deep Glow?
I love to put it on everything, even pretty much everything, and then crank the radius up to the max of 2000, and then just change the intensity down to like 0.01. So it's like really, really subtle, but you can just tell it's there. And that sort of emulates the look where, sort of like a filmic look where there's a lot of diffusion in, well, not a lot, but just a small amount of diffusion in when the things are too bright. I just like to get away from the pixel perfect look that, you know, when you create something on the computer, it's pixel perfect. I want to try and make it look a bit more natural and realistic. So I literally add chromatic aberration and deep glow to nearly everything, but I'm subtle about it. So I, you know, if you see everything soaked in chromatic aberration, you're like, get rid of it. But if it's just a tiny little bit or a tiny little bit of diffusion and glow, I think it really adds a lot. And so literally use it for everything. So Deep Glow, although we're up to version 1.4, is still a work in progress, and we are working to create introduce some really cool features in the future. I have no idea how long it's going to take, but certain things like custom lens types or custom apertures, at the moment you don't really, I mean, you can change the aspect ratio, but that's about it. It would be really cool if you can, I don't know, emulate that look that Daft Punk has in all their videos, where all the glows are sort of, you know, in a six flare shape and things like that. That would add a lot of flexibility and customization to it and really let you create infinite styles. We're just in the testing stage at the moment, but that's definitely something we are committed to in the future, but can't say how long it's going to take. Another thing that I really like to add with pretty much every glow that I do is at the super, super brights, you add sort of like a lens texture of dust on the lens, and you sort of alpha matte that to where to where the brightest part of the glow is. But that's always tedious because you have to pre-comp it and then add in another thing. So that would be another feature that I'd like to add in. Maybe the next version of Deep Glow is you just supply it a texture, or maybe it comes with a library of textures. And yeah, in one click, you've got your camera scratches and things like that, because that just adds another level of realism to dirty up or grunge up your computer graphics. So Deep Glow, we have some pretty cool features coming up, but you know what else we have coming up? More YouTube content. I want to die now.
What should they do about that, James?
Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, because although we've committed to it before, to making more content, now we're super serial about it. We are gonna create actual content. So we're aiming for one video per week. And also, I forgot to ask, if you guys have features you'd like added into Deep Glow, please add a comment, because you guys know what you want in your Glow plugin. And yeah, tell me.
Can you say goodbye?
Goodbye, everyone. See you next week.
I'm just gonna leave that.